Bonjour, c'est un
Good morning.
Plaisir de vous recevoir
I'm very pleased to welcome
Merci
you
à tous ceux
here
qui sont
today. Thank you to everybody who's connected online. Thank you to our partners from the French Institute who are serving us at the
Merci
Cinéma du Monde Pavilion. Thank you to the European Union and the organization of ACP States, Africa, Caribbean and Pacific, who are following us as well. I'll hand over to you, Madame Directrice. Today you're going to present the WeCo Prod platform. First of all, I'm sure you'd like to welcome our guests. Good morning. I'm Nivine Caleb, I'm Director of French Language and Diversity of French-Speaking Cultures at the OIF, for the French-Speaking International Organization. I'd like to thank Cinéma du Monde for welcoming us here today, as they have done for many years already. We are in a long-standing cooperation and very fruitful cooperation, which is continuing despite all the difficulties we've had this year. And we are delighted at our organization to be able to continue with this work. The DNA of our company means that one of our priorities is to promote cultural diversity in all forms, whether it's for books, live performance, visual arts, of course, also what's bringing us today here, which is cinema and cinema production. As my colleague has said, we are here today for the official launch of this platform, which we are going to launch today. WeCo Prod is the name of the platform. We hope it will make everything possible. It's a platform for collaboration between different partners. It's a platform for visibility of producers who we hope to bring together to create synergies between them. We hope to help them through our consultants and experts, and we hope to help them find financing. We're also here because three of the films supported by our organization have won prizes in the different selections. The Moroccan director, Nabila Ayouch, the Haitian director, I've forgotten their name, Mr. Genus, and the Egyptian, Omer Serio. I'd also like to say that also we have Image Bank at the Organization of Spanish-Speaking Countries, which is brings together the work of many producers and directors, not only for help with production, but also help with financing and film organization itself. If you like, I'll now ask us to be able to start looking together at the trailer for the French-speaking world Image Fund. This is a film which we supported in 2019.
Et avec toutes les facettes du prisme qui me compose. Pourquoi l'amour entre deux êtres de même sexe fait l'objet de tant de rejets au sein de notre communauté?
Tina Ahoua. Tina Ahoua. Majbartashi tsuira ma Tina Ahoua.
Bien. So
welcome to Marie-Clémentine and Thérèse Ndiambo and Kim Bao, who've joined us. I'll hand over to them in a moment. First of all, I'd like to explain to you a little bit the activities we've had this year with the French-speaking Image Bank of Fun. We've seen some excerpts from the films we supported last year. Three of those were at the Venice Film Festival, and one of them won a prize at Venice, and two of them were shortlisted for the Oscars. And this is, we're something very proud of this. We have three films at Cannes this year. The objective of the fund or bank is not to get prizes, the objective is to make films possible.
Nous adressons aux pays francophones du sud.
We work with the southern French-speaking countries where systems to provide aid and the possibility for making films are more difficult than in other countries.
L'année dernière,
that is why
avec bien qu'on ait toute cette fierté
last
pour
year, although we were very proud of the art house cinema we produced, we have decided
une priorité
to
put
the priority to give specific support to the ACP countries and from Africa, Caribbean and Pacific. We've launched a program called the CLAP ACP, which is supported by the EU and the organization of the ACP countries, Africa, Caribbean, Pacific. The emphasis placed on these territories and these regions of the world is to support the producers
les fonds
and the national funds.
La difficulté que j'ai un blanc tout d'un coup.
My mind has gone blank all of a sudden. I'm sorry about that. I wanted to talk a particular difficulty. What I wanted to say is that it is very important for us not to work alone as the OFP has been done for 30 years, but to support the national funds that exist in Africa. That's why the CAP ACP program has been set up. The Ivorian Fund called the Cycle Fund, and we have eight other national funds involved. We feel it is important, although we have this vocation of helping films produced from the Southern Hemisphere, it's important the countries themselves should be able to have systems that will help them to have long-standing structures to enable them to structure their production, to help them not only help them film by film, but to help them work on a longer-term basis, to give the film industry in their countries a stronger basis, and to make them more, give them more experience and more better armed in the international film market.
Le mécanisme du programme CLAP ACP
mechanism of the CLAP ACP film has focused on co-production aid. Why would we focus on co-production? It's because, first of all, it helps films to be stronger, it helps them to reach wider audiences, and it gives the producers in the southern countries more experience who are used to working alone. We want to encourage the co-productions to be south-south.
Entre les pays africains,
between
entre les
African
pays
countries,
pays
between Caribbean Pacific. Countries, and between Pacific countries. The mechanism of the CLAP ACP has two parts. The first part is a financial part,
pour chaque
where for
aide, pour chaque subvention que nous
each
un film,
subsidy we give to a film, the EU
des ACP
and the organization of ACP states provides a bonus which can be 100% to 200% of the original aid provided. So that is something that can really change things completely. When we give 40,000 euros to a film, we can actually provide it with 120,000 altogether, thanks to the bonus from the EU and the ACP state organization. In addition to that, throughout the year, we have provided individual and collective support to the producers. This support started for each of the products we were supporting by giving them a consultancy services to provide what we call a diagnosis of their product. We selected various experts for fiction, documentary, and series
who prennent le projet et
look at the project
and
give possible advice for rewriting, analyze the production structure,
apporte des conseils,
provide advice,
et permet au projet
de
s'orienter d'une façon plus sûre.
To be on a more stable and secure path.
We have also
provided training to give pitches. We provide artistic support for editing.
Et puis, and on s'est rendu compte que
we have also realized
l'accompagnement pouvait être aussi collectif.
That support could also be collective support. Let me explain why. We realized
depuis quelques années,
over the last few years
d'une créativité extrêmement bouillonnante,
is a fantastic creativity in all of the African countries, in the Caribbean, and in the Pacific countries, we're starting to discover this creativity that we're starting to see now in the festivals. A lot of African films that have been selected recently, several African films have won surprising awards in Venice and Berlin, etc.
Les plateformes, paradoxically,
which we thought would bring standardization, have focused more on African production and have taken more risks than the TV companies. They realized that this was working. There are two series we've recently supported,
one
called Sarko Mangan, which is a fantastic success on Netflix, or Wara, which is a series from Senegal, which has the title the most frequently seen documentary on TV Plus network. We are frequently contacted by producers and TV channels and festivals and laboratories.
Ils ont envie d'aider
because they want to help the African projects, but they can't find them. They can't. It's difficult for them to select them. It's much less well-known territory. They don't know it very well. And on the other hand, we have producers. Some of them are in the room with us today,
who
are struggling every day in Africa, in Haiti, in Vanuatu. These are not easy countries to work in.
And
obviously, they need production finance to make sure their film is a success and becomes visible. And they need to have obtained loans, etc. So on the one hand, we have an ecosystem which doesn't... We have on the one side, we have producers who outside a structured ecosystem. On the other side, we have a structured ecosystem which would like
commencer à s'intéresser et à s'investir dans des projets de
start investing and working in with these films and from territories they're not familiar with.
So
if we want to be really useful,
c'est sans doute en étant le lien entre cet écosystème
providing a link between this ecosystem and these isolated producers.
They
would be
create
a meeting point,
a
link which will enable them to meet up. This is a platform we've called WeCoPod that I'm going to present to you today.
Je vais demander à l'écran de voir.
À my colleagues to show on the screen.
Non, pas tout de suite en fait.
No, not straight away.
J'ai quelque chose d'important au début.
First of all, I want to say something else important.
WeCoPod
is a project platform where we present about 50 projects we supported last year, whether it's the French-speaking Image Fund or the Côte d'Ivoire National Fund. These are fun projects in all different, many different formats, different types. Documentary series, we have fiction, of course, in feature length and shorts as well. It's a platform you can look at straight away on by typing wecoprod.org. It presents projects all of the different audiences. You can be informed of the films that are going to be arriving on the market from Africa and the Caribbean and Pacific in the next 6 months, 2 years or 4 years' time. Above all, it's a platform which is targeted at professionals, producers, television, distributors, the agents,
the foundations,
the labs, the different funds, the different sponsors possibly for series as well, etc. So a digital shop window we wanted to set up.
Dont le but, en fait,
and
est
the aim
de
of it
permettre à ceux qui cherchent des projets
is enable those people who are looking for projects
alors
to find them.
Quand on crée un
course, when you create a website and a digital shop window, it can be on the web, but people won't be able to find it. That's a problem we were explaining earlier, the making something discoverable. Who is going to want to find Wikopod on the web? The problem, when you, if you want to emerge on the internet, is the algorithms that exist on the web. So we said, okay, we're going to set up this digital shop window, but we have to be able to make use of six algorithms, and these six algorithms are six people. It's important
pour que ces projets soient trouvés,
for these projects to be found by people looking for things on the web. We have six experts, two for fiction, two for documentaries, and two for series, who, first of all, have done a huge amount of work on each of the projects to format them and to put them in the right format that is required by the international market. And then by using the networks with the festivals, labs, producers, and TVs, TV companies, they will be able to put the producers in contact with the projects, the television channels with the projects, so that we can work in both directions. In other words, we can work to make sure the projects have the best possible exposure and so that the potential partners are able to find them. So now I'm going to show you this. This is a platform that speaks for itself. At the moment we have 52 projects from Africa, Caribbean and Pacific. These are projects that are fictions, feature length, and documentaries, series and animated films. As you can see, quite an interesting balance between the two, these areas, 26 from West Africa, 16 from Central Africa, 7 from Eastern Africa and Indian Ocean, 6 from the Caribbean. In fact, it's more than 52 altogether because there are co-productions, in fact, between them. So we have a documentary, it is from Mali, which is co-produced with South Africa and Cameroon, for example. So these are projects that are at different stages of development. There are 23 projects that are underdeveloped. They're being, where they're still writing and looking for funding. 21 projects are in pre-production or are starting to shooting, the shooting process. 8 projects have almost been completed. So how does it work? It's very simple. For example, if I want to see fictions, I click on fiction. And here I can discover a film that is a co-production between Burkina Faso and Nigeria, a wonderful epic film from Chad, a short film from Burkina, an animated film from Cameroon, a Haitian film, a science fiction film as well, from Congo, another Haitian film, an Ivorian comedy, which will be on release very soon. So if I just look at a project at random, we have one. This is a film for Rwanda. This is what you will see on the site. You can see very simple information, the duration, the synopsis. And here you can see there's a lot of data which aren't visible because these data are for professionals. These will enable a partner to understand whether this project is interesting for them or not. So we'll find information about the artists, about the producers, about the finance, about the budget, the support they've already received, the contracts they've already entered into, and above all, to find out what the project is looking for. So that's for the general public. It's always interesting when you're a film lover to see what you're going to have an idea what you're going to see in Cannes in 4 years' time. But if you're a producer, you can just register here. You have your professional access, and then you have the same page again. The Benjamina film, and here you'll have what Marie Clementine will talk about this later. She'll explain why she's making this film. We have notes from the producer about where the project has got to, what is its production strategy, and then a data sheet for the film where we'll find the budget that has already been found, and a whole series of documents which are already available. For example, is there a script in English? For example, is there a video pitch? Is a mood board. Sorry for using these English words, but we're supposed to be French speaking. But this basically enables a producer to very quickly, in just 10 minutes or so, get a an idea of the potential of the project and can look at different, several different projects. As I said at the beginning, it's very difficult to identify projects in a territory you're not familiar with. You don't know whether they're going to be interesting for you or not. At the OIF, the Image Fund, we receive between 500 and 600 projects a year. Our partners from Fonsic receive about 50. And this shop window can also be open to other funds as well. I'll talk about this later. But all of the projects on this platform are projects that have been examined in detail by a very selective commission, a very demanding commission, and have already received funding. They've been chosen, and they are projects that have already received funding. They're not open completely empty-handed. They have already obtained funding by themselves. As you've seen, I'll hand over to Marie Clémentine in a moment. Here we have the site which gives the biography and the film history for each director. Last time I showed this site to somebody who was working in the US, they said to me, that could be very interesting for agents as well. If you go into the talents, you have all of the directors. If you an American producer, Canadian producer, you want to make a film in a particular region, for example in Haiti, you'll be able to find directors. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 directors from Haiti who are already working on projects, already exist, projects that have already received support. And then we have the same thing again for the production companies, looking for a co-production partner in a particular country. As I was saying, this is just a digital shop window. It's a nice presentation stand, if you like, but it's not going to work all alone by itself. We've chosen three partners by a system of tendering. Initiative Film for production. I'll say a few words about each, and then we have Andrew Film Lab for the Art House Films and Discop for series. Their role, first of all, will be to work with each of the project leaders. This is what they've been doing already over the last 2 months before Cannes. And in the second phase, they will support these projects with their partners. We'll be very concrete, and so we're very pleased to have with us Marie Clémentine, Le Bay Jungle, who's one of the projects we're supporting, and Kim Mao is working at Film Initiative Film, and is accompanying all of the fiction projects on the platform. So Marie Clémentine, we'll go back to your biography. Where is it? We can't find it. Marie Clémentine, I've known you for 4 years because in the office there was a short that had obtained the Thomas Ankara prize. A few years previously, she won a prize at Tribeca. And then she was at Cannes for a film I worked on, which is the Neptune Frost, which will be at the director's fortnight in Cannes. And we're very pleased to welcome the Benima film, which is supported by the OIF as well, and which is the well received initial funding from a young French-speaking organization with it's already been attracted funding already. Can you tell us about your project and tell us a little bit what stage you got to in your project? Thank you very much, Elko. I'm very pleased to be here. It's the first time I've been in Cannes, and I'm very pleased to be here. The Venimana project, is the idea I had the idea in 2012 after the short film I made, with the which was at the Tribeca Film Institute. I wanted to talk about the post-genocide trauma in Rwanda. The film was in 2012, and it looks at it from the point of view of three generations of women. You can find more information on the website. It's had a number. The film has had a number of residences from Kwanagilab. And last year, it was supported by OIF, who also provided their support thanks to ACP. And through ACP, we were able to work with the Initiative Film,
who
gave us an online workshop.
This
also gave us support with the artistic side. We learned to give pitches as well. And at the moment, since January, I've been in Paris. I'm in residence with the French Institute and Visage du Monde.
This has helped me
continue with this collaboration with Initiative Film. They've given me some feedback on the scenario. And also, they've also provided support on the legal side as well in January. This has added huge assets to the film. It's greatly improved the film. And it's very useful and interesting because we have French-speaking countries film creation fund, which is provided a bonus in addition to ACP. Now we're looking at co-production partners, especially in Europe, to get more funding because we still haven't got up to 50% yet. We're at 30% of the funding we need so far.
Et donc, justement, Hakim, c'est un projet qui
I think, Hakim, you can tell us a little bit about this project. You've been supporting it for a while now. What can you say? Can you tell us about the work you've done with this co-production?
Yes,
we've been working, helping Benamina.
And we, via
OIF before we co-prod, and to say a little more about our structure, Initiative Film, which is a bit unusual as an algorithm in charge of the fiction feature and the feature-length part of the we co-prod. We work on developing movie-making projects and audiovisual industry, created in 1993 by Isabelle Fauvel, who will say a few words a little later on.
We cover quite a broad spectrum, but only area of production which ranges from consultation on analysis of scripts, but also casting
the scriptwriters and also searching for suitable works for directors and producers, and also training through writing workshops and labs. And the training to give pitches and video pitches ever since the COVID has started. And so because of this broad spectrum of missions we provide, it means we are able to create networks and relations. This is a very important part of our work, because through the institutions and organizations we work in, through our private customers and the talents and projects we meet every month, very often we find ourselves putting in contact
qu'on soit missionné à le faire ou pas, parce que je pense justement qu'il peut y avoir des synergies intéressantes, des collaborations qui peuvent naître, et du coup,
they could be interesting projects, it could be developed.
Remporté so en fait l'appel à projet, grosso modo, pour les consultations sur scénarios via l'OIF, on a eu d'un coup scénarios
pour l'OIF. That gave us a huge scope for projects which we hadn't visibility about before. We weren't familiar with the ACP region, and we weren't completely disconnected from these regions. We discovered a huge variety and richness of projects. And after intervening as a consultant on these projects, we found ourselves giving people advice in addition to advice about the script, more broadly about development, about what the future steps and projects could be for them, to see how they could continue developing their script, if they wanted to have a workshop or benefit from a lab. For example, to also explain to them how they can make their project more visible, depending on what kind of partner they're looking for, and also to put them in contact with potential partners.
They could be co-producers
or distributors
dans notre fichier de client, mais c'est un accompagnement, on va dire, un peu qui peut se faire un peu dans les coins et de manière non-officielle et pas forcément systématique pour chaque projet. Et avec l'OIF, on s'est dit qu'effectivement, trouver un outil qui soit à la fois indépendant, ergonomique pour que les gens en recherche de projets puissent venir trouver ce qui leur correspond et à la fois très humain avec des experts qui pourraient venir
human so that experts could intervene before and afterwards to promote these projects to potential partners. We thought this would be very relevant, especially as these are projects that have already received help and are in a process which is quite active in terms of production. And they've already received funding, and in some cases they've already got to the stage of completion, and so this is how we became involved in the EcoPod adventure. And as we intervened as a consultant
on
projects for giant platforms,
we are
also in the right place to be able to support them and to be able to editorialize without
defining the format for their content so they can be presented on the platform in the best possible way for potential partners. Le bon dosage, le bon équilibre
right
et la pertinence des informations présentes
right
sur la plateforme
information to be provided
pour des professionnels,
for professionals,
soit du nord ou du sud, pour favoriser justement
south, in order to optimize meetings.
Merci beaucoup, Hakim. Et donc, vous avez commencé
Hakim.
Un petit peu à Cannes, ici,
started talking about those projects to several people. Now, what direction did you take to
le travail de présentation des projets?
How, what direction do you take to present the works?
Well,
in fact, we realized that this is a very interesting place for films and audiovisual projects,
even those that have been completed.
So a luxury for those platforms is that
l'éditorialisation de contenu et la mise en lumière qui fait que les gens dans un océan en fait de possibilités peuvent se repérer un petit peu plus efficacement. Et nous, c'est un peu comme ça qu'on axe notre travail en expliquant que WeCoProd, c'est certes une plateforme avec pour l'instant 52 projets qui est vouée à grandir, mais qui permet de vraiment cibler et d'aller à l'efficacité, ce qui n'empêche pas les surprises. Et au-delà de ça, nous, on essaye de faire un accompagnement
surprises and
we're
trying to accompany on a very personal basis the project that we are well aware of. And when we're consulting, we're trying to see what would be most efficient to go to the next step. So for first version to a version requiring financing, for instance. And we also try to adapt
people
so that the right project meets the right people at the right time. Yes, precisely. I agree with that, and we are very happy to start with you all here in Cannes. And we also work for movies, but series and documentaries. And I thank you very much for your presence. And I'm going to ask to Faisal Lionfin and Dieudonné Alaka to replace you.
Donc, Faisal.
So, Faisal.
Faisal Lionfin est un
Faisal Lionfin is a producer, an active producer in France and Benin.
Partie de cette jeune génération de
producteurs africains. Young generation of African producers
produisent et coproduisent
that produce and co-produce fictions, documentaries and series.
Ça prouve qu'on a besoin de producteurs en Afrique parce que le sol est absolument partout chez nous.
Il
est à la fois coproducteur d'une série qui s'appelle Mamiwata, qui est presque finie.
Samantha Bifo, who's at the Fabric du Cinéma, because she also produced another movie that we'll talk about later. So, co-producer on Mamiwata, co-producer on a Chadian fiction, which is also called Mamiwata. But if he's here today, it's because he's co-producing two documentaries,
and
especially
Visa à tout prix,
a documentary which is called Visa à tout prix, a Visa at all costs. And maybe I'll leave you the floor, because if I say more, you won't have anything else to say.
De Visa à tout prix,
so let's talk about this.
Je vais commencer par remercier l'OIF.
I first wish to thank the OIF for supporting us on the project, because Visa at all costs is a project.
Schengen ouvre-toi, c'est plus facile.
Bon, ça y est, vous êtes revenu sur le titre Schengen ouvre-toi.
We might call it Schengen open up, in fact. And it's the project of a young man from Togo. And I've been supporting him for 3 years. And there were different development stages, but they were rather complex. And eventually, last year, we were supported by the OIF for the development of the project.
And
it is a project I'm co-producing with a Senegalese company, Sedete.
L'OIF nous a permis de faire des repérages en 2000 l'année dernière,
go on location last year,
avec un teaser,
and to have a teaser,
qui nous a aussi permis de
and the fund also allowed us to go on writing the project so that it's been represented in production. Can you sum it up in a sentence, because it's a Benin and Senegalese production, but the action is set in the Ivory Coast.
Yes, it's
French, Benin, Senegalese production, and it is set in the Ivory Coast because I started the project with an author, and first it was set in Togo,
but
after 6 months we lost a character. But I didn't want to give up the project because I thought the idea about immigration was really interesting, and the treatment of immigration was different because we saw some use using the legal path to go abroad, and some agencies are being implemented all over Africa so that papers and visa can be gathered.
Dans les recherches,
while we were searching in three, four West African countries, and then we found characters in the Ivory Coast.
Visa, en fait.
So it's about the legal business of visas.
Le de départ, Schengen, ouvre-toi, on est revenu là-dessus,
the original title, Schengen, open up.
Ça résume même si dans nos personnages il y a la partie américaine, mais ça résume pour nous l'Occident.
Because it sums up the Western world, which is why we came back to the original title. So it's about the legal business of visas of young people or businessmen that go abroad.
Dieudonné
Alaka,
qui lui-même est producteur,
you're also a producer of documentaries and fiction.
Le fondateur du Yaoundé Film Lab,
the founder of the Yaoundé Film Lab that is with us, is an expert company for documentaries on the Wiko Prod platform.
C'est allumé, hein?
Yeah, is it on? Yeah, okay.
Oui, merci.
Well, thank you.
Merci Enrico. Merci.
Thank you, Enrico. Thank you, the OIF. But I wish to have a precision on the film's title. Is it Visa at all costs, or is it Schengen open up? Because I don't want to talk about your movie using a fake title, so you have to give me the precise title. All right?
C'est Schengen, on va le changer.
Yeah, we'll change it to Schengen.
Okay. Moi, je parle beaucoup. Hein, donc,
you know, I talk a lot, so I'll be advertising the movie everywhere, so because I wish it to be successful.
Titre,
so
cas, we have to be precise upon the title. Le Yaoundé Film Lab, effectivement,
Fessol
n'a plus trop à se soucier, que ce soit sur Aljana, comme tu disais, Enrico, il est sur beaucoup de projets.
Moi, je crois qu'il devait parler d'Aljana, qui fait partie effectivement de l'Ecoprod, mais là, il parle de Schengen Open Up, donc ça, c'est une très bonne chose. Je voulais juste dire
qu'au sein du Yaoundé Film Lab, nous avons déjà la chance d'avoir un accès prioritaire sur les documentaires, c'est-à-dire que on travaille beaucoup,
that is, we work a
avec
lot
beaucoup d'autres experts,
with many other experts and trainers on documentaries.
Qui me passionne d'avoir moi personnellement.
And I'm really,
I
have a passion for documentaries. I've been working on those for five years.
Donc, c'est déjà un premier pas pour
so it is a first step
non seulement nous, on travaille avec Eugénie, mais not only ces formateurs experts work qui sont dans le
with you, but also trainers and experts which
pour accompagner les projets documentaires.
Documentaries
que nous encadrons dans le, au sein
that we are trying to help within
WicoProd.
And I think we will be working in synergy
because concrètement, hein,
very
crois,
concretely,
on a commencé déjà à le faire.
We
on a
already started doing so. We had a small launch,
dit,
and our first challenge will be for people to
parce
know about the WicoProd.
Il faudrait qu'on réussisse à mettre cela partout dans le monde, dans les esprits
it has to be everywhere, all over the world, for financial partners, international producers, TVs. So we have to communicate and be efficient, and they can understand that today there is a platform dedicated to accompany projects from southern countries. And if you can keep on dreaming, well, you know, I have a problem.
I had
several support, financial support from the OIF, but the thing is, if you keep going on, then there's a problem because you're looking for some more money and it's not made. So I think the platform would be a great asset so as to make sure the projects are being completed so that we can use consultants. And try and find opportunities on all areas of the world.
You know,
sometimes I have trouble sleeping because we're trying to look for support in South Africa, Canada, Japan. And try and find possibilities for collaboration because this is the new standard today. People want to discover new continents, they want to discover African projects, Caribbean projects, and we do need serious people to talk to, people with the experience. Directors, so that
donc
we can accompany them.
Et nous
and
on va
it
faire
is
ce
a great opportunity for us to have WicoProd.
Panel,
and
un réseau
concerning
assez vaste
documentary, we have quite a broad
Eurodoc,
network
Vision
with Eurodoc, Vision Pluriel.
Il y a des Film Lab qui invite pas mal de formateurs.
And, Film Lab that invite trainers in South Africa, and we work with many different people
donc,
and countries.
Pour dire un mot, so Fessol, il peut dormir chez lui aujourd'hui et savoir qu'il y a quelqu'un qui ne dort pas.
So sometimes I'm really worried and I keep looking for new suggestions.
Vous avez commencé vraiment à
yes,
à
in fact, you started working
très de balayer sur le
very in many different festivals
oui,
in Switzerland,
Canada
South
aussi.
Africa, Canada. What is the feedback in fact? What is the answer you obtain?
Oui, elle est très très positive.
Well, it's
c'est d'autant plus positive. Que c'est une opportunité d'entrée. Moi, en tant que producteur, j'ai été,
as a producer,
fois,
I was a consultant. But I also had this difficulty
avec,
to be
les producteurs dans d'autres pays comme au Canada. Là, on a un motif très sérieux qui est d'ailleurs accompagné par la francophonie. On a un motif très sérieux qui est Wikopro, qui me permet aujourd'hui de discuter avec des rencontres internationales du documentaire de Montréal.
International meetings, for example,
novembre,
in Montreal,
pour présenter
in
surtout
November,
la plateforme, comme je l'ai dit, c'est par là
qu'il
faut insister pour que les gens puissent avoir le réflexe. Après, je ne sais pas la magie que vous allez faire au niveau des algorithmes pour que ça devienne très, très automatique.
And we also have to work upon algorithms so that this becomes automatic. What I understood is that you're more efficient and you can be heard when you have a selection of 10 or 12 documentaries that allow you to come in as someone with more power for lab festivals. Yes, as you say, because
if you wish to be heard and to appear serious,
well, we have 55 projects and
effectivement, well, Isabelle, moi et Patrick, on travaille avec elle, on travaille, on va beaucoup travailler en synergie
pour pouvoir,
lorsqu'il y a une ouverture, comme c'est le cas peut-être
be able
Canada,
and there's an opening
like
in Canada
to
present the platform and then be more specific concerning
documentaries
because the festival is focused upon documentaries. With Vision du Réel, we were to present Wikoprod, and I think we'll do it also at the Écran Noir, at the FESPACO. So it's a very serious motif. It's important, and it allows us to highlight documentaries in all those festivals.
Trouver un moment pour discuter avec tous les
it will allow us to find some time to work with all the partners which are present there. So there are several international partners in such festivals and they wish to have constructive and serious talks. And we have projects that are already finished, others are ongoing, others are being shot. Yes, some projects are also have been finished. Some were won an award in Copenhagen. You were talking about labs and festivals and Isabelle Fauvel. And I would like her to give us some sort of overview on the strategy that will apply.
Thank you, Frida.
And if you're here until the 14th, Frida is on, has been selected at un certain regard and it will
merci
be
beaucoup,
broadcast on the 14th. Thanks a lot, Faisal.
Coup de théâtre.
Bonjour à tous.
Hello everyone. It's always difficult to conclude when everyone has said everything.
Je voudrais juste dire que je
but I wish
que
to say that I was not. I never thought I would thank COVID one day in my life, but in fact I am thanking COVID because normally at initiative films we never answer the call from vendors because we're too late or we are overwhelmed by our work. And Hakim mentioned it very clearly. It's very nice. To have young partners, in fact.
Et en réalité, and quand on a répondu au
in fact, when we answered the first call for tenders, that allowed us to enter the intimacy of development of projects for ACP countries via the OIF, it was for us a way to find some sort of visibility on a continent where I had some workshops for literary adaptation in Cotonou and in Mali years ago, and I realized that I didn't know what was going on there. And when I saw production, they were finished productions and movies. But the question was, what don't I see and which is behind? So a year and a half ago, I was in a similar production position than many producers, agents, or movie fans, as they are now.
And when we had the idea of Wikoprod, Il faut avouer que l'OIF a été extrêmement rapide.
And in fact, the OIF was really reactive and quick because we had the first discussion last June.
Entre Enrico et nous,
and Enrico and us were talking about it. So it was very quick. The longest time was the work of the graphic designers and the people who set up the platform, because that was probably very complex, and maybe we could thank them.
Oui, merci beaucoup à la
agency Lomitco, which developed this in 3 months' time.
En fait,
yes, and also
besoin,
they understood what the users would need, that is aesthetic visibility,
and
also that would recapture what is necessary to be known. And the difficulty in initiative film was to have a format without standardizing the productions. Because there is a standardization of writing, which I will not mention today. So we wanted it to be aesthetic, but not using mannerism. And we also wanted the project to be clearly identified. And we are very happy to launch the project in Cannes. It's a new project. It's an essential tool when you're trying to give visibility to projects, talents, and a continent. So we're all on board. We didn't know one another. The expert companies, well, I don't like the word expert, but I'm using it. And of course, there is no... in fact, documentaries, fiction, cinema, and series tend to blend one another. And even though we have different characteristics, in one department each, we will be welcoming many new projects, and we wish to evolve, because when the films do not need us any longer, they will disappear. We will keep in mind the talents that brought the projects to us, because it is very interesting, even culturally wise, to see who's growing, who's evolving, who's winning prices, and we will welcome new projects with the same exact spirit, that is, make sure that there was a creative dialogue with every expert company so that we know what we're talking about. So initiative film for us has not really started in concrete terms, but we started talking about what we wished.
It is grâce à ce qu'on voit à l'écran que en donnant un flyer, d'ailleurs c'est pas très logique de donner un flyer, en donnant un flyer, en rappelant les gens après, là il y a une façon de travailler qui est révolutionnaire, mais qui est tout à fait adaptée aux besoins d'aujourd'hui et aux nouvelles
données. Ce qui est important, c'est d'arriver à prendre place dans tous les lieux et les forums,
make sure that we are part of all the locations, forums and workshops that are working on helping movies to be produced. And we have several partnerships with Durban,
Venice, and also with La Fabrique, ce soit pas une vitrine de l'OIF,
the idea is that
mais que ce soit un service
only be a showcase of the OIF, but a service that would allow to show us the cinema world and all the people looking for a project coming from Africa and the Caribbean, projects that have been supported by the OIF or the World Cinema Fund. So we will integrate and welcome within the platform projects from all of our partners, that is one from Durban, that will come from Wicoprod, another one from Venice, and there's also a project from La Fabrique, and we're very happy about that.
Amédée Pacôme.
This is the project of Amédée Pacôme
Nkoulou,
which is called The Frescoes of the Forgotten, and I saw the first version of the script, and we are very happy to have your film very soon on our platform.
Yes, what you're saying is key because I was part of the Torino Film Lab second year it was started,
and
we participated in workshops
in several countries,
or because we were invited in several countries,
because it's difficult for sometimes to find experts or mentors,
and we saw
this system of exchanges which developed in a very healthy fashion with people from labs who said, well, if I come to the country, maybe I might take on board a project from such a country,
and creates a dynamic
in some sort of virtuous cycle. So I think this is a natural complement to all those novelties. Well, for me, this is the 36th Film Cannes Festival, but we've been having those workshops in the last 15 years, and it's a nice way of accompanying the work
that might
sometimes fall down or lose momentum if we do not reach the next step. Thanks a lot. So we've just launched WicoProd. It's been online in the last hour. I thank you all for your attention. I thank the interpreters that might say the last word in English to the 200 people listening to us online, that they can go on WicoProd, yes, for yes, it's possible, coproduction.org, and you click on Access Pro and you will have all the information for artistic financing.